again. I'm so glad I'm on the road again, telling people all about my friends. I'm so glad I'm on the road again.
Hi, I'm Jesse Lee Turner, and I'm proud to be an American and excited about being your host of Our Land USA, where the adventure begins.
Come along as we visit past and future friends of different occupations and backgrounds who have made a lasting impression on me and many others, and who have had a divine intervention in their lives. We will visit towns and places with interesting histories as we travel from adventure to adventure in this great land of ours. Hi, I'm Jesse Lee Turner. And I've been blessed in my lifetime to have been a singer, songwriter, author, actor, missionary, pilot, businessman, and producer. And now I'm glad to be back on the road again, traveling from coast to coast, highways and the byways, showing what makes America the greatest country in the world and how God has blessed her. For copies of today's show, contact us at jesseleeturner.com or jesseleeturner111@gmail.com or call us at 936-414-2551. Thank you. Hi, I'm Jesse Lee Turner with Our Land USA, and today we are truly blessed to have a guest named Miss Diane Rose from Waco, Texas. And her story is going to just touch your heart, and her talent is going to amaze you. So I want you to say hello along with me to Miss Diane Rose.
Hi, Jesse. This is an honor to have you in my home with all my different colorful items.
It's an honor to be here. We've talked several times on the phone, saw you on television before, and been just really intrigued with your talent and your love for the Lord and your love for the people.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I love color, though I don't see color anymore.
You lost your vision at 18, I believe you said?
No, in 1984. And 4 days before a cornea transplant, the cornea ruptured and fell back to the retina. And I was born with glaucoma, so I had light perception and color. I was able to get around, but I couldn't see to read print, and I always read Braille, and I did everything I can. I got involved in all kinds of things just because. I was a blind skier, snow skier. I used to snow ski.
What age were you when you lost your vision totally?
I was in my 20s.
In your 20s. Mm-hmm. And you were living in Nashville, is that correct?
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. I lived in Nashville, Tennessee. I was a Nashville reporter. I was a tour guide. I did interviews and wrote for various freelance writer for various country music magazines and a Nashville reporter where I called radio stations around the country and told them what was going on in Nashville. Spent many Friday and Saturday nights backstage at Grand Ole Opry. That was my family. I loved it. But things changed, and people retired, and people died, and the new generation came in, and you kind of fell out. And circumstances beyond my control, I moved to Texas, and here I am. In 1985, I guess, I had gone to prayer lines all the time about getting my vision back, and I was, Kenneth Hagin came to the church I was at, and came up afterwards and said, I want to pray for you, and not for your eyes, not for your physical eyes, but for your spiritual eyes. And he said, God's going to give you a talent. You won't be aware of it now, but when you will, it will take you around the world. You will bless millions of people. It will be colorful, and it will be something that will be unique and different. And you'll stand before kings and queens. You'll stand in front of presidents. You'll know dignitaries. And you're going to be used in such a mighty way that you've never been used before.
Amen.
That was the prophecy. And 14 years, 15 years later, I learned to quilt in 1998. And it was, I was so honored. A lady, well, now I'll back up a little. Barbara Fairchild is a friend of mine, and I was with her one time, and she said she was quilting. And I said, what are you doing? She said, oh, I'm quilting. And I said, oh, I would love to. She was hand stitching. And I said, oh, I'd love to do that. She said, well, Diane, you got a C to do that. Well, 10 years later, after I learned to quilt, 10 years later, I saw Barbara Fairchild, and I said, how about this? And she said, I'll never tell you you can't do anything anymore. So don't tell me I can't do something, because I'll prove you wrong just to spite you, because that's who I am. So in 1998, a lady in the country asked if I knew how to sew, and I said yes, and then she taught me how to quilt. First, I started with polyester, and I hate it. I hate polyester now. But that was August 14th of 1998, and by January I had already made 6 quilts.
Wow.
So, what is this? 19 years later, 1,000 quilts. They are all around the world. Prince William and Kate have a first baby quilt. George W. Bush has one. Rick Perry, Greg Abbott. And President Trump will have one before it's all over, because I will meet him this next year. In the name of Jesus, I will get to hug him and meet him and have a tour of the house. I am speaking that into faith.
And I agree with you.
I'm speaking that into action. You know, faith without action is dead. And I mean, I live on that. I believe God for that.
You know, you said something to me earlier that I think the people would like to hear. You said that when something tragic happens in your life, which it happened to you, that you have a year to mourn or whatever, to get over it and then to move forward. Talk about that again.
So I want to encourage people that when you lose a spouse, a friend, a loved one, an animal, a limb, your hearing, whatever it may be, it's okay to grieve for a year, okay? Because you go through a process. And after that, you have to get up those bootstraps and you got to go forward. You got to make goals. You got to have those dreams. Don't put those dreams in the box and lock it, because those dreams is your future. You have a future. You are on this earth for a purpose. God has you here for a reason, to do something, to make a difference. If nothing else, to make a difference with you, to do something. So don't give up and put that gun down, put that knife down, those drugs. No, you don't need that. You are better than that. You are beautiful. You are handsome. And you are a wonderful person. God made you who you are.
Amen. I agree with you. And I know you've also said that you don't consider your loss of sight a handicap as much as just an inconvenience.
Oh, gets in my way, yes. Yes, it does. Because there are some things in life that you need assistance with. I travel by myself, and I love that. And I speak in various places around the country, and I'll go anywhere around the world. If God sends me there, I'm gone. I am looking for a personal assistant, a lady for the time being, but like my mail sometimes, or spot cleaning, things like that. You need another pair of eyes. Or when you go shopping, hey, I'm on good deals. I don't just take it off the shelf and get it. I don't have that kind of money. I ain't rich yet. but you have some, you need us. Everybody needs somebody. Everybody, you need somebody. I need somebody. We all need people. We all need one another.
Well, that's a great outlook, and that's positive, and that's what keeps you going, and it should help other people to keep going. I know I had a tragedy in my life, and I had to get over it and go forward, because if you're looking at the past, you're just standing still.
Yes. And you've got to forgive.
That's
sometimes
correct.
Sometimes when you have a tragedy, you blame a person that may have caused that tragedy. You have to forgive that person, and you have to go on. it's, you know, you're hurting yourself more than them by not forgiving them. So forgive them. A lot of people ask me, because I was never kicked out of the house or nothing. I left home on my own at 18. Okay, got on an airplane, went to a brand new state, brand new city, started life over. Not that I was abused or anything like that. I just, I know my dad loved me. My mother was another story, which I'm not going to go into. I think she just knew how to love me in her own way. I don't know. But I can tell you, because I was rejected from my family, does that mean I have to dwell on that? I don't have to say, oh, he did this, she did that, and hold on to it. I've let it go. I can't even remember half of this stuff, because what good is it for me now? Don't look at the past. Look at the future. I have a future in front of me. You do too.
Amen. You know, and it's like I was talking to Sid on the way up here about keeping his vision, and you've kept your vision, and I've had to keep my vision. Mm-hmm. And the Bible says, without a vision, man perish.
Write it down. Like it says in Habakkuk, write it down.
And work toward it.
Mm-hmm. Like, okay, you opened up the book, Jesse. You opened up the book. Okay. God bless me with a piece of land in Branson. I believe to build a house debt-free. Now, I don't know if my husband is going to see this and he's going to come into my life to do this. I don't know that. But in the meantime, I'm going for that. I believe debt-free, building a house, to be able to help other people with disabilities or even older people that need something. I need a giant sewing room with a big sewing table.
Right.
And a room that could be a display room where I can have all my quilts hanging there. And things. I believe at sometime in life, I will have a gift shop, be able to have people come into that gift shop, because it's not just the quilts. I have pot holders and pillowcases and pillows and stuffed animals and baby books, all kinds of things. But that stuff's not on the website. It's little things. And I speak in churches and schools and all kinds of organizations.
So you're open for any church to call you, an organization to come speak their meetings,
mm-hmm.
church meetings?
Lions clubs. Even a lot of the airlines, they always have a, like what Jack Canfield, does. I cannot wait to meet him someday, to be here to put my story in a chicken soup book. Why not?
There you go.
Why not? Why not be able to build this house? Jesse, hold that up.
Yes.
This is just a rough drawing of the house. If several different television evangelists can believe God for $3 and $4 million for their ministry, what's $350,000 to build a house, a custom-made house to what I really, really need? I have the land. Need to build the house. I know there's someone to donate the bricks. I know the electrician. I know there's a carpenter. I don't know who you are, but you do. And I know that God will bless you back 1,000-fold for what you'll do.
Now you gave what you saw in your vision of this to someone, and they laid it out for you.
Correct. Actually, some kids did it. I did this to a friend of mine. She did it in print, took it to her husband. He put it down on the computer with the measurements of the piece of land, and then the kids took that drawing and laid it down with the Legos and the buttons and all. And here's the thing. The cool thing is, when you walk into the house, in the foyer is a picture of Jesus. And under that, I'm going to have a plaque with everybody's names on it who participated in building a house for God. This is God's house, not Diane's house, not me and my husband's house. This is God's house. It's going to be his people that are going to come together to build this house. I know it. I see it. I feel it. I just don't even know how to explain it.
Well, Branson would certainly be a spot, because you get a lot of tourists coming into Branson.
And see, I'm used to
where they could
that
come and buy your quilts, mm-hmm. and different things that you make, and help and donate or do mm-hmm. what it be part of the ministry.
Yes. And there's so many people there that just looking for something to do.
Right.
And I could be a part of different things. I love to to be able to serve and help people, organize. I'm an organizer. I could teach organized classes, no problem. You know, people ask me, you know, how come you always got it together? For example, I do a festival. I have all my tubs are all labeled. What's in the tub? When we pack up, you put it in the right tub. I was like, why do you have to be this way? And I'm like, why not? You got to put things back where it belongs.
They're very well done. I wished I could. The camera will not show you the quality and so forth of her quilts and the different things, but they're very, very beautiful. And you can go on your website and see a lot of it, correct?
TheAmazingQuilter.com. All the quilts are on the website, are for purchase, and Christmas is coming up. And if this is shown after Christmas, you got other holidays, and they are all handmade. They come with a certificate of authenticity, and they are also numbered, and they give instructions how to wash them. And I love doing what I do. And I look forward to hearing from each and every one of you. You can now purchase a quilt on my website through with a credit card. I do like the personal touch. I like it when they call and tell me, I want quilt number such and such. And I do UPS the quilts. And I've been to England, and I loved it. I'm ready to travel anywhere around the world. I do have some goals. I believe God to be married this next year. God will bless me with that husband to come in. And the house to be built. Go to Australia. Hopefully to be able to go to England to the royal wedding. And be on Mike Huckabee show, Steve Harvey show, and anything else where I can share Jesus and what he can do for you.
That's great. Well, I'm going to be in agreement with you that these people are going to come forward and you're going to touch their heart. They want to be part of your ministry, and they want to help the people that have handicaps or disabilities or inconvenience, as you prefer to call it, and want to help them. And, you know, what's important about that, Diane, is that when the Lord stepped into my life and called me, and I thought, I was called to go into the ministry, and I mentioned it to someone, and they said, well, what do you think about that? And I said, well, I don't want to go into the ministry unless I would be successful at it.
Amen.
He said, well, what are you calling success? And I said, well, I don't know, big church, I guess, whatever. And he said something that changed my life totally toward the ministry. He said, Jesse, he said, do you realize if only one person got saved because of your ministry, then you have been a success. Your ministry has been a success. And that's the way you are with your ministry.
Yes, sir. You know, God wants us to be prosperous and productive, and he wants us to have, you know, all we have to do is ask, and then praise him and thank him for it. Believe it into existence, you know? He doesn't want us to be poor and down on the mouth, or
right.
So however that is. But, and I love to make people laugh. I just look forward to meeting each and every one of you some way, somehow. I do answer emails. I do Facebook. I do what I can. And the man that God has for me, you better love my kitties, because we're a package deal.
Do you plan on taking your kitties to Branson with you?
It's part of the house. You think of course I would. This is Buttercup. She's 17 years old.
And I believe you said she lost her sight.
She did a couple months ago. She just became totally blind, so, which is really amazing. The blind leading the blind around here.
So, well, you both do very well.
No cane, no glasses, no dog. I got the cats. They're fine. No, I don't. And that's something that a lot of people will ask. Why don't you do those things? Because that's what society expects. And I break all rules of society. I can tell you that. I did go to public school, and I've even had a lot of people through the years say, why don't you do this? Why don't you do that? No, that's not me.
Well, you are a blessing. And
thank you.
I'd like for you to just to say whatever you'd like to on as we close the show out. Whatever's on your heart, just face the camera and just
talk. Father, I just ask that you bless each and every one of these people that watch this show. And Lord, I thank you for answering prayer. I put out my request. I thank you for bringing this into reality. I thank you for each and every one of my friends that have come into my life and the fans. And Father, I thank you for the people to purchase these different quilts. And yes, I do custom made. And Lord, bless Jesse. Bless him now as he goes forth. And Father, we just give you the glory and the honor. And Father, I thank you for the husband that you have for me, that he will know me in the spirit, just like I will know him in the spirit. I thank you for that. I thank you for the house. And Lord, I just glorify you, and I give you the honor and the praise. In Jesus' name, and everybody said, Jesus is Lord. Amen. Hallelujah.
Well, Sister Diane, praise God. It's so great having you on the show. Thank you so much. We'll have
You're
to
welcome.
Do it again.
Maybe don't forget to check out the amazingquilter.com, or you could Google my name. That's fine.
Well, I'm in agreement with you that the Lord is going to answer your prayers, and there somebody's going to come forth, or some people will come forth to help you build this home,
yes.
So you can help the less fortunate,
yes.
Other people, and it'll just be a blessing to many.
Amen. I receive it. I receive it.
And I agree with you. In Jesus' name, it's going to come true.
Amen. Thank you.
And I know that, you know, Diane, that's in 33 years of walking with the Lord, that's one thing that I can say without a shadow of a doubt. God's word does not come back
void. No, sir.
Does not come back void.
When people let you down, he will never let you down.
Right.
He will always love you. He will always be there for you. And you could call him on him anytime, day or night.
Amen. Amen. Well, Diane, once again, thank you. And Lord bless you. And we'll look forward to having you on again someday.
Amen. Thank you, Jesse. God
thank
bless you.
Folks, thank you so much. Go to our website and look at the stuff. It's just wonderful. And you have a blessed day in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. TheAmazingQuilter.com.
Amen.
You can feel good too. If you like music from the golden age of rock and roll, you're going to love Jesus in the 50s, 60s, and 70s, volumes 1 through 6. Jesse Lee Turner was a true rock and roll star in that golden age of rock music. He takes hit songs that you know and love and rewrites them into the gospel. Get all 6 CDs, a total of 65 songs, for the low, low price of $49.95.
Gracious, praise God again.
These songs have blessed thousands, and they're fun to sing, dance, and praise with. These songs are loved by all ages, and you will enjoy these great songs for many years to come. And they make a wonderful gift for any occasion.
Your heart.
65 awesome songs from the golden age of rock and roll, rewritten and sung by Jesse Lee Turner to sow God's word. All for the low price of $49.95. Call 1-800-273-0665 and order yours today.
For copies of today's show, contact us at jesseleeturner.com or jesseleeturner111@gmail.com or call us at 936-414-2551. Thank you.